Jimmy Lee's not in any trouble.
Hey, Joe, what are you doing?
Are you in some kind of trouble?
No, no, we're right on schedule.
No, no, I mean with the cops.
What?
I mean, that captain of homicide, what's his name, Ramsey, he was snooping around the trailer. Now, I got out of there before he saw me, and... Well, I just thought you ought to know, just in case.
Thanks, I appreciate it. No, I'm fine, I'm fine. I'm clean as a whistle.
Okay, I just thought you ought to know.
Thanks, I appreciate it.
What are you doing?
Huh?
You're in the middle of something?
No, nothing. Can't wait. What can I do for you, Commissioner?
Oh, just a little chat.
Sure.
Why don't we sit over here?
If it's something to do about last night, I already talked to an officer.
It's what happened before last night that I'm most interested in.
I don't get you. What do you mean?
We're of the opinion that Tolliver was working with someone. All indicators seem to point to you.
Oh, come on. You gotta be kidding.
Mm-hmm. Tolliver was blackmailing the Quartermains. Makes sense to me that he'd want you in on it.
It might make sense to you, but it doesn't make sense to me.
You had a grudge against him, so did he.
So what? I got other ways of dealing with people than blackmail.
You were seen at Susan's. What were you doing there?
I went to Susan's. She called me. She invited me over because she knew who I was. Thought maybe I'd like to get back at the Quartermains. But when she told me what she wanted, I said, pass.
Why didn't you tell the police?
First of all, it wasn't any of my business. And second of all, it was just words. I didn't know anything was going to come of it.
Well, maybe Tolliver could have told you.
What? That's pretty good, since I didn't know Tolliver then.
You were in jail the same night that Susan was killed. The same night that he had somebody impersonate him just to get thrown into the drunk tank.
So?
So, if you had a suspicious nature like me, you might be thinking that you helped him pull off this little charade.
I don't have a suspicious nature like you, and I don't associate with people like Tolliver.
You gave him a job.
So what? He was an old man. He came here, needed work, that's all. And yes, he did ask me about the Quartermains. But he knew that I wanted nothing from the Quartermains except the recognition of who I was, mm-hmm. Edward's son.
In that case, you tell me, why did he drag himself all the way from Susan's with a bullet in him, all the way to the Quartermains, just to see you?
He didn't just come to see me. I was happened to be outside. I saw him. He was bleeding, so I helped him. What's he supposed to do, leave him there bleeding?
Okay. So, you weren't working with him and you hardly knew him.
That's right.
In that case, why did he give you the papers?
Listen, I don't know what you're talking about, okay?
If you were at Susan's, you knew about those papers.
Yeah, I knew about the papers, but I've never seen them.
Then why did Tolliver give them to you?
He didn't.
Come on.
Look,
you'd have had the Quartermains right where you wanted them.
Look, Scorpio, I don't have the papers. If you don't believe me, just search me, okay?
Go ahead.
Go ahead, search me, man.
You'd hardly be carrying them on you. No, just in case.
You know, if I wanted to get at the Quartermains, if I wanted any money from them, why didn't I just do it when I first got into town, huh? Well, I didn't. And if you don't believe me, just ask them.
I'm going to find those papers.
I hope you do.
Hey,
Jimmy Lee,
I need to talk to you.
Hey,
help about something.
What's going on?
Well, it's about Lulu.
What, she giving you some kind of trouble?
She wouldn't be Lulu if she wouldn't give me trouble. Look, I gotta go to New York for a few days, and I need someone to watch out for.
Hey, listen, she looks like the type of girl can take care of herself to me.
Yeah, well, she's something. Look, I haven't really been honest with you, Jimmy. This girl's in bad trouble, all
what?
Right? She's in bad trouble.
What?
She's a runaway. She landed up here. She's got a rotten family. Dad used to beat her and stuff. She landed here, she got involved with some weird guy, and I don't know. Just take my word for it. She's in bad trouble. She's got some guy chasing her.
Well, what do you want me to do? You want me to talk to this guy?
No, no. You can't talk to him because he doesn't know she's still in town. Listen, I know it's a lot to ask, and I haven't really told you much, but she really needs your help. I mean, if you could just watch her till I find a safe place for her, it'd be great.
Man, you looked like to me like you got a lot of responsibility. You took on a lot of responsibility, man.
Yeah, I know I did, but I know what it's like to be in trouble and have no one to turn to.
So do I.
Yeah. All right, I really appreciate it, really. Let me give you some money. Take care
of it. No, it's all right. She needs any money. I'll take care of it.
Oh, you're a big high roller now that you're quartermain, huh?
I might be a quartermain by name, but I certainly don't have their money.
Yeah, well, you'll be rolling the dough pretty soon. Don't worry about it.
If I am, it's going to be on my terms, my own money.
All right.
I'm not taking handouts from anybody, believe me.
Right. That reminds me. Old man Quartermain called. He wanted you to meet him at the house. In his words, I'm the double, he called me. So get over there. Hey, I really appreciate all your help, buddy.
Hey.
Really.
Anytime. Right. You owe me one.
I know it. Anytime. See ya.